Hey guys, I'm Chace Crawford, and this is The Breakdown. Deep is sort of, completely in his own way, and never feels like he's, good enough for going to be that. He wants to be the number one guy, kind of knows he, or thinks he's like the number two guy, behind Homelander. But all of his insecurities really come from, we talked about this, is like, feeling like a freak. You find out he's got these disgusting gills and doesn't like taking off, his suit ever. And it's very, sort of vulnerable for him. I kind of want to create that weird, like, vulnerability when he, sort of has his comeuppance and sort of gets assaulted as well and gets his own taste from the other side of it. So Deep's definitely like in his own head and in his own way and on his own journey to sort of, of like self-discovery and needs to latch on to something or someone who's reaching out with a fresca, and offering some sort of, some sort of self-help in a way. And I just thought that was really funny and interesting and weird. But he's definitely separate from the seven. I think I definitely, it'd be nice to work, it'd be nice to work with some of the other guys again. So maybe they can find a way to get the Deep back in the mix. I love working with Jesse and everybody, Anthony. I think some of the early small Deep Homelander scenes were really interesting and funny and weird. And so I'd love to get back in the mix, but it's been fun to show his journey and to sort of be a little bit of comic relief and also, some darkness and what have you. But he's definitely on his own,
That's right. Next stop, the Atlantic Ocean. That's right. That's right.
What? They really let me run with it and make up stuff and sort of massage the lines and make it my own. But yeah, when you're talking to inanimate objects like a dolphin or a lobster or my own gills, it's really lonely. No, it's great. I mean, it's definitely stretches you a bit. You know what I mean? To really focus in on what that other character is saying to you, because on set it's just someone calling out the lines someone off set just kind of saying the lines, and so you really, it's almost like an internal monologue or dialogue, really. You have to really internalize it. So it is funny, and I've learned a lot about the edit and how it, how it cuts together and certain reactions and stuff like that. The dolphin scene was a lot of fun, but those things are, it's you got to match the energy level, because you're just sitting in like a dark warehouse and the van is static and there's just kind of maybe a green screen to your left and people are just kind of shaking the thing, and there's like video villages right here and people are just sipping their coffee, just watching you talk to and squirt down an inanimate dolphin. So, matching that energy level and really, really going for it was something I kind of learned as we went. And that was a funny day though, because I didn't want to get cut, because I know some of that stuff is really weird. So I was just trying to figure out a way to make it work. And thank God it did. So
what's up, man? How'd you end up here?
Oh, tell me about it. Me too.
I think that's what's interesting about our show. One of the main through lines and themes is that Crippy always talked about, is that it's not just the silly superhero theme. It's definitely a lens and a world to show, to reflect and talk about real world issues, whether that's, Stormfront this year and even Homelander embodies his own thing, Jesse or A-Train has his own thing. And to be able to talk about that, I mean, it is, the comics were written, 10, 15, maybe more years ago, and they've never been more like prescient with some of these themes. And I like that Kripke doesn't shy away from that. He even sort of went even in harder on season two to reflect that. But I think also when with some of these people and characters in real life, someone like the Deep can also, in a really bizarre way, he feels like the victim. You know what I mean? They get over that initial, like, I'm sorry. What else do you want from me? You know what I mean? I'm apologizing, when he's just not getting it. He still is defensive and deflective. And then it can sometimes turn into anger and pushback, and he's just not there yet, you know. So he still hasn't really fully grasped, you know, that he's canceled. He just can't really, you know, grasp it. And that's, you know, season two, he's obviously developed a bit of a lava flow drinking problem, and you know, is just angry at the world and can't sort of get out of his own way and figure it out himself.
Dolphins. Did you know in Japan that they hunt down and slaughter 20,000 dolphins a year? Intelligent animals. Yeah, that have regional accents and great sense of humor. I mean, they're they're hilarious.
I didn't realize there is sort of like a sub-passionate debate about Aquaman. Some people are really passionate about it. And I think after season one, I don't really like check Instagram that much or DMs, but I think I got some, like, you know, like, fuck you, Aquaman wannabe. Who do you think you are? You know, so I'm like, wow, people really like, it's, you know, we're not, the show's not about a takedown on any one character. I think Eric, obviously, and the show in general, the writers were wanting to have fun with that. And, you know, what's interesting about the show is what they did really well too, with the costumes. They got the top of the top to make it look like real cinematic, the full costumes, and they feel like you've seen these characters before. You know what I mean? Like, even Homelander, obviously, it's amazing. He looks like Superman, you know, Captain America type. They feel so real within the world, and even the lighting of the world is so natural and good. So I think that from the outset, that was definitely a goal of Eric's and the show, was to make them sort of feel like we've seen these guys before, and to, you know, but it's in its own world.
I'm going to do everything in my power to renew my light. Not just for you, but for all the female people that I've offended.
Renew your light? Did you just fucking join the Church of the Collective?
Maybe.
You're an idiot.
Hey, easy on the religious persecution, okay, new girl?
Every villain thinks they're the hero of their own story, you know, and thinks they're doing the right thing. And so you can't really judge the character from the outside. You have to, you know, think what makes this guy tick, what makes him think that he's the hero of his own story, you know, and what is he going through? I mean, the Deep's going through more of a personal journey, but, you know, what makes him think he's vindicated, or you know, what's he get defensive about? What does he get angry about? What does he think he's, what makes him think he's right, you know? And so that's kind of looking, pinpointing those things and sort of using that as the guide, and then sort of just letting the chips fall where they may, you know. It's, I didn't know what the reaction necessarily would be. I did feel like some of the Dolphin stuff was funny and turned out well, but yeah, people do sort of empathize with him a little bit in a weird way, even though he's completely like irredeemable and unforgivable and a monster of sorts. But yeah, I don't know, again, I just keep that as sort of my North Star, and then just keep opening the scripts and reading these curveballs and taking them day by day. So